Captain Larson, may I say something?
Sure, go ahead.
You are the most complicated collection of paradoxes that I have ever come across. You send Johnson aloft. He may be dead by now, and yet you exult in devising...
You've come here to talk about Johnson.
Yes, sir. To plead. To beg. What satisfaction can you get from brutality and snuffing out a man's life?
The earth is full of brutality, as the sea is full of motion.
But a man's life...
Life is the cheapest thing in the world, Hump. There is only so much land, water, and air. But life demanding to be born is limitless. And nature spills it out with a lavish hand.
You've read Darwin.
Yes, and it all comes down to might is right and weakness is wrong.
And you've misunderstood him.
No. You see, Hump, Johnson holds on as though his life were a precious thing. To me, not at all. To himself, yes, but he overrates himself.
And what value do you place on your own life, Captain? Some of the crew are...
plotting to kill me. You see, I know everything that goes on board this ship. Even what each man thinks. Well, let them try. And you're welcome to try, too. But I'll make my own death as I made my own life, alone. From cabin boy to master of my own ship and destiny. But I'll tell you what, Hump, I'm feeling generous. And it serves my purpose to keep this scurvy crew together a while longer. So I'm going to let Johnson come down. Even though I can't abide a man who doesn't finish what he starts.
Thank you, sir. By the way, Captain, the lady, Miss Brewster, she's going to survive.
Is she? There are a great many hazards aboard a vessel at sea, especially for a lady.